We want to talk about the Serbian Mastiff and especially its recreation thereof, so the Serbian defense dog. As mentioned, there were once Serbian Mastiffs, which are a working type of Mastiff, and they were becoming extinct, and then they were recreated, and they used Bosnian Ternyaks, if I pronounce it correctly. It's like a closely to resembling that of a Pyrenean mountain dog, and that herbalist that recreated this breed also used his domesticated tribe of Serbian wolves. So those were the local species that they used, but you can see in the Serbian defense dog it looks like a molosser with a short coat. So what they did, especially, is crossing short-coated molosses and Buon terriers. And what they used were, as a molosser, especially the Massino Napolitano, which is a big guardian type of dog, also very good in band dog programs. And they combined this with other breeds, for example, the Rottweiler especially. It's also a very good working molosser, and as a standalone breed, and they combined it with American Staffordshire Terrier, which is more of an all-round farm dog, and game bred American Pitbull Terrier. So in my opinion, the Serbian defense dog, albeit they state that they use some Serbian wolves and also some long-coated livestock protection type of breed, is in its essence just a version of a band dog. So crossing Buon terriers, for example American Staffordshire Terrier, but especially American Pitbull Terriers, which are just the same in the past. American Staffordshire Terrier is like a show version of the American Pitbull Terrier, but more of a farm dog. It's also good for protecting against evils on two legs. And American Pitbull Terrier is like the best game dog ever, and they use game bred version of that. And combining that with the size of a big molosser, Mastino Napolitano, and also a German Rottweiler, results in a quite nimble, strong band dog type of dog that's very capable. Oh, yeah, now I remember, it's a Bosnian Ternyak, if I remember correctly. That's the big livestock protector that looks a little bit like a Pyrenean mountain dog of Bosnia. But you don't see that long coat anymore in the Serbian defense dog. It could very well be that this added genes, especially of the ancient genes from the livestock protector, but more so from the wolves, have made the dog even better at living in harsh conditions, and perhaps also healthier, so that they have a high lifespan, life expectancy, which are good things for a quick dog, which I do like. And also like that they use Rottweiler, which is a very capable, strong working mastiff. And also many times in band dog programs they just use mastiffs, for example the English Mastiff or the Mediterranean Mastiff, which don't always have that working character, whereas the Rottweiler is still used quite heavily as a protector and defense dog at its own merit. But now, while adding game dog blood and also increasing the size of the other molosses used, this could be a very good dog. Much more nimble than your average Rottweiler, with similar bite strength or even surpassing it. More size, more determination, and also a better fighter all around. So I really like the Serbian defense dog, and I find it quite interesting that they use, in this case, als er some other long-haired dogs and even wolves. You see this often in the eastern parts of the world. For example, Russia, they also had a program where they developed dogs for military purposes by interbreeding, for example, German shepherds and wolves. So they're quite respecting the nature and the survival instinct and also the capabilities to withstand harsh conditions and the health of the wolves. And I think that's a very good thing. It could also be that in the future some wolf pups adding that to for example crossing away from it again very rapidly. 6% would give enormous benefits in adding to the gene, so enriching the gene pool again. And you will not notice the wolf blood that much anymore. I think if the first cross between the American Terrier and the wolf, you could already select the dogs that closely resemble that of a American Pit Terrier, let alone the second cross, where you only have 25% wolf blood left. So the Serbian defense dog, there it is. In my opinion, they could have used, instead of this Bosnian type of cognac, they could have used, for example, Turkish Kanko blood, which also look a lot like Serbian defense dog on its own, but they didn't. So perhaps there were some things that could be even better in the Serbian defense dog, but I truly do not think it is this way. Also, in the Dogo Argentino dog that I love, they bred in some Pyrenees mountain dog to get that light coat. This is not the reason, I guess, that in the Serbian defense dog they use that cognac. But more of local reasons, and also sometimes local reasons are right. Eh? Good dogs are where you find them, and they are closer related to the Serbian Mastiff of the heydays. So I can understand it in that context as well. And also they are able to survive the conditions there, same as the wolves. And I think it also has resulted in a very nice and balanced working animal, which I really like. In my opinion, the Eastern Europe, Russian type of dogs are often better than the average European. And why is this the case? Because they select on working capabilities still. If you, for example, look at the Moscow watchdog, this is a dog that closely resembles the European Saint Bernard, but has still working capabilities. It's a good protector. And they use, of course, some other blood in that mix, especially the Ovčarka, which is also a local dog. But they made a lot of improvements to the Saint Bernard, also the health and the functionality of the breed. And I think this is a very good thing to do. Also, if you look at the Eastern European Doberman and Rottweiler, they are often better than those they found, for example, in the United States. It's not that in the United States they don't select good, because they, for example, produce American Pit Bull Terrier, but their stock is different. I think they started a lot with show breeds, better in the US as a ranked elegant type, instead of a working type. This is a bad thing, and if you then have to work for that stock to speed again, you have your work cut out for you. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video, and also please check out this awesome breed, the Serbian defense dog, which is very well received by me, and also in my top picks for that size of dog. Have a nice day. Bye bye.